Yes, it felt just a little bit more ramped up. It is the second season. Let's take a look at the forward goaltending matchup. Corey Crawford, a terrific season. The goals against was third best in the league. The save percentage, fifth best in the entire National Hockey League. And we told you about the big story that happened in warm-up. Nicklas Backstrom, who led the league in wins. Look at this. He tried to make a little move and came up lame. He's had some hip issues before and some knee problems and limped off the ice very gingerly. He will not play tonight for the Minnesota Wild. A devastating loss for them. And there is Josh Harding. The last time he started a game, he only started three all year. The last time he started was at the end of January. And he gave up two goals and four shots against the Hawks and got yanked. That was his last start at the end of January. And this opening round playoff game is underway.
And this first period of Blackhawk playoff hockey is brought to you by Hyundai. Visit MyHyundaiChicago.com.
Here's Ryan Suter's partner, Brodin. I mean, this is a great young player. We talked a lot about Suter, and rightfully so, but this kid's 19 years old, Brodin. You're going to see a lot of him, too, because he's Suter's partner, and he has really been a terrific find for the Minnesota Wild.
Yeah, a real good skater and a real good compliment to Ryan Suter. For the Blackhawks and that breaking news, Pat, with Nicklas Backstrom being out, you want to get pucks to the net. You want to put some pressure on Josh Harding.
That dump in attempt was deflected, so it results in Clutterbuck going offside. Now, you're the Minnesota Wild. Your workhorse is out of the game, and you want to play a defensively structured system anyway. Now for Mike Yo, and he's only got one defenseman that's ever played in a postseason game ever. That's Suter. They got five other D-men. This is their NHL postseason debut.
Well, if you're questioning your team's mental toughness, Pat, and with that happening in warm-up, you're really going to see what your team's made of. And it's the hand that's been dealt, and you talk about adversity, it's there. But the Wild, I don't think, are going to change their game, Pat. If they don't have any pressure, they're going to have five guys back, just like they are right now. They're going to force the Blackhawks to try to dump the puck in, and they're going to have to go get it. And they're going to put the pressure on the Hawks that way by being less aggressive when they don't have the puck.
All right, now the Wilds, Bouchard will get things reorganized. Spurgeon, Minnesota trying to change on the move here. They'll be able to dump this in, but it deflects out of play, so we can show you the officials tonight. We have not mentioned yet the official. The referees are Tim Peel paired up with Brad Meyer. There's Brad and the linesman Pierre Rassico with Darren Gibbs, and kudos to all those guys and any other officials who are working in the postseason. That's a great compliment to their work. There is a cut down for NHL officials, just like there is for NHL hockey teams. They're not good enough in the postseason, in the regular season. You don't get to work in the playoffs.
There's an evaluation process to your statement, Pat, and officials get an opportunity.
Shaw put it in behind Stahlberg. Couldn't quite reach it. This one, we're 2 minutes in. I think there have been four pucks out of play. Souvenirs for everybody.
Well, there's a good look at Coach Q, Joe Quenneville, and understanding what has taken place. And I'm sure anytime that type of thing happens, Pat, where a big part of the other team's lineup goes out, as a coach, you must address that with your team and let them know, hey, you know what, you got to work even harder. You know, you give the quick scouting report on Josh Harding and you go from there, because there is that human element of, well, the number one goaltender's out, so, yeah. You know.
Here's a chance for the Wild right in. And a backhand chance went wide. Crawford seemed to get dinged as Zucker went racing right through the goal mouth. His left leg was out. He was a little tender getting up.
Boy, he got the inside step there, and I don't think he realized. Watch the stick right there, Pat, of Brent Seabrook. I think that threw him, Zucker, off stride there, and there you see go crashing right into Corey Crawford. Never picked up his head until the last second. By that time, he was on one skate. He was on that left skate, and no chance to avoid that. I think a good non-call by referee Tim Peel, who was to the right of Corey Crawford. But what a chance there for Zucker right off the bat. Great speed. Got a step on Brent Seabrook, and Seabrook never gave up on the play. Got that stick in there. Didn't take a penalty, but I think it just threw Zucker off enough to give him something to think about.
Harding sends it over to the boards, and the puck held in by Keith. Koivu followed up, bounced it to center ice. And here's Joel Quenneville with the last change, and he's done it all year. We get the Hawks' fourth line out there, the top line on for Minnesota. A weak backhander into the glove of Harding from Kruger, and the whistle sounds. We remind you, as you enjoy a cold one, to look forward to Miller Time later tonight, brought to you by Miller Lite. It was funny. Talking to Brian Bickell this morning, Eddie had just asked him, you know, who he thought he'd be matched up against, and he said, what the heck? I don't know. We don't match up against anybody. We know we just kind of roll four. And what coach? I'm not sure you can fill up one hand with a number of coaches that would be confident enough in the first shift for each of these lines. His fourth line's out there. The other guy sends his top line out there, and he doesn't change him.
That certainly sends a message inside the room and the confidence level, and the players got to go out there and do the job. And you know, I think certainly the situation will dictate that, Pat, if it continues or if the Hawks are behind or if they're, you know, continue to have the lead. You look out there, almost a giveaway by Oduya.
The Wild looked like they were going to pull back to the middle of the ice, as you talked about earlier, then with the Hawks sort of standing around on their own end. The three forwards came in. And all of a sudden, a near problem. Now it's back in Chicago ice. Rosenthal with it. Looks for Toews. His backhand pass well out of the reach of Brandon Saad. Now Patrick Kane, the fifth leading point producer in the league. And Seabrook looking back to Kane. That was a waist-high pass, though. Going to go all the way down. And is there icing? Yes.
Pat, what we're talking about, and the Blackhawks are going to see a lot of this from our Xfinity Telestrator. Puck's behind the net. Stop it right here. Here's the puck. It's getting moved up. Look at the Minnesota Wild. Look at where they are. They're all in this area here. Not a lot of pressure. They're going to say, you know what? Get to the red line. Dump the puck in. We know you want to play a fast game, to play a game, to try to trade chances. So the Blackhawks have to make good decisions, isolate one side, Pat. So what they'll try to do is move the puck to one side, get Minnesota moving that way, and then throw it quickly back the other way. So it's important that the forwards come back with speed in order to try to break that system or that trap that they're trying to play in the middle of the ice.
Hanzus rolled it ahead. Kane's got it, weaves to the middle. Kane hangs on, shoots it, and it might have got off a skate out in front. And then the puck cleared back the other way by Scandella. Marco Scandella will be a guy to keep an eye on in this series, playing the minors virtually all year. Sharp to Kane. His pass never got to Hanzus.
Good stick there by Stoner.
Now back to Kane. Patrick Kane back to Seabrook, a long one-timer. Hit some traffic in front. Gilbert up the boards. Seabrook kept it in. Gilbert again. Able to bounce it ahead to center ice. Now Jalmerson ahead for Bickell. In it goes. Shaw chasing on Stoner. Good contact in the corner, but the puck cleared up the boards, and Clutterbuck carries it into the Chicago end. Cal Clutterbuck shooting. He scores! Cal Clutterbuck, 5 minutes in, snapped it from not the best of angles, and it's 1-0.
Well, Cal Clutterbuck started over on the right wing boards, Pat, and he worked himself all the way over. There are three Minnesota Wild players. Look how close they are. They're so close together. He's skating left and shoots back the other side and gives up. Corey Crawford gives this goal up on the short side. I don't think there's any doubt he was anticipating, Pat, that puck to go to the glove side, the far side. Not a good goal given up by Corey Crawford early, especially on the short side from a guy like Cal Clutterbuck.
The first shot on goal of the playoffs for the Minnesota Wild goes in, and they've got the lead. Now Shaw against Koivu. Chalmerson rolled it to the corner. Stahlberg after it there. He won the puck. Victor Stahlberg tried to center. Too hot to handle for Chalmerson. And back they come. Coyle unable to complete a pass. And Shaw will put it back into Wild ice. Stahlberg arriving first. the three white sweaters there and taken away by Suter. Ryan Suter ahead for Parisi. Couldn't get it out. Keith a long shot, missing the mark. And Brodin couldn't get it out. Eventually it did deflect to center.
Good job there by Brandon Bolick to take a run at the youngster, Brodin.
Quick shot by Frolik is up high. Now a four-man battle in deep. And then Mike Rupp turns and shot it back the other way. Letty pursued by Torrey Mitchell.
Boy, he got on his horse there awfully quick. I mean, you thought Nick Letty was going to cause separation there, Pat Mitchell. I mean, he didn't lose stride. It looked like he was almost gaining on Nick Letty.
And Mitchell racing in against Letty again. They collide. Oh, look out, an awkward fall into the boards by Mitchell, but he perseveres trying to dig it out, could not. And Seabrook able to move it to center ice. Bowling couldn't get it very far. Zucker the other way. Jason Zucker looking to drive the net on Letty. He's able to one hand with a poke check to prevent a shot. Now it's held in by Gilbert. Nope, not quite. And the Wild have to go back and tag up.
Well, Zucker's had two good chances, Pat. One from the left side, one from the right side. Same type of play, just speed to the outside.
Setoguchi is checked to the blue line. Now Johnny Oduya gave it to Michael Roosevelt, a rink wide for Saad. He gets it in. Saad to the forehand. Centered it. It deflected away from Hossa. He retrieved. Now Jalmerson up on the play. Jalmerson to the goal. He shoots and a save by Harding. Jalmerson, as he was taken down, able to get it to the net. And now Saad was checked. A whistle and a penalty coming up against the Wild. Oh, the Blackhawks down a goal. We'll get the game's first power play. And we talked about it. It's postseason time. Get ready for some more of that.
Welcome back to United Center, up at press level, presented by the Chicago Acura Dealers. I'm Tracy Myers for CSNChicago.com. The Blackhawks entered this postseason as fresh as they ever have. Playing more balanced minutes helps, but so did all the rest that Coach Joe Quenneville gave them during a regular season. Duncan Keith said credit the players for using that time to recoup and regenerate. At this time of year, that's what it's all about. Pat Nitti, back to you.
Thank you, Tracy. Go to CSNChicago.com right now and check out Blackhawks Pulse, presented by AT&T. You can interact with Tracy and your fellow Hawk fans by using the hashtag HawksTalk. Well, an opportunity on the power play. One of the better penalty killers. Boy, oh boy. That's an awful call.
Wow.
That's an awful soft call there on Mikko Koivu. Looked like it was just a hockey play and strength against strength.
Well, Danica Patrick is used to speed, and she's going to likely see a little bit of it in game one here tonight. The Hawks power play with his first chance of the series. Finished the year four out of the last 14. That's over six games. Suter looking to clear, and he did get it out. Now here's Colin Hussling. He's going to get there. Colin is in shorthanded. And a save by Crawford. Back comes Kane to Hossa. Marian Hossa chipped it in for Andrew Shaw. Taken away by Suter. His clearing attempt hit the glass, went out.
Well, an opportunity here for the Minnesota Wild. Duncan Keith tries to play that with a skate only, Pat. Would have liked to see Dunk use his stick on that play as well. And here comes Matt Cullen, but a real good opportunity. Watch the hustle here by Andrew Shaw. Look at his hustle. He keeps his play alive. He wins the foot race. He wins that battle. Puck retrieval on a power play, so important. Good hustle there by Andrew Shaw. And a good stop there before by Corey Crawford. Against Matt Cullen.
Hayes winning a draw, so Hossa will ring it around. Harding out to play it. That was not up on the glass, so he could play it. Now he lost it, and it's taken by Keith. Kane to the middle. Here goes Hossa. There's the pass. Here's the shot. Good block by a sprawling Spurgeon out in front. And Parisi's clearing attempt deflecting out of play. It's not that likely we're going to see a lot of special team play, Eddie, in this series, at least based on regular season numbers. Let's take a look at this play, though.
Now Patrick Kane walks the wall, gets this puck to Marian Hossa, who's playing the point on this power play unit here, and you mentioned good block there by Jared Spurgeon. Good discipline on both sides. The penalty aspect.
The Minnesota Wild were only shorthanded 135 times. That's the lowest number in the league. The Hawks were 141. So, I mean, here's two of the four teams that were least shorthanded during the regular season. It hopped away from Sharp and is out to center. 45 for the Hawks power play.
Patrick Sharp out here with
Saad and Kruger are up in front on this power play. And Kruger walks the wall trying to get in behind. Marcus Kruger spins it for Patrick Sharp. Sharp, the shot into the glove of Harding. And Marcus Kruger, who gets a power play time here, had one goal, one assist over his last 14 games of the regular season. So some power play minutes for him early on. Now the first unit back for the last half minute of man advantage time, which is Taves, Hossa, and Shaw. Now the Wild have Cullen work into the middle. He lost control of it. And now Patrick Kane starts back. Kane picks his way into the zone. Brings it around, Shaw. Andrew Shaw. Now it's dropped back to Hossa. Here's the man out of the box, and it's stolen away by Koivu. As Hossa didn't know he was coming, Koivu gets it into the zone, dropped it for Mitchell, bouncing puck, back to the corner, then off the side of the net. Keith retrieved.
Only have one defenseman on the ice right now. Marian Hossa makes the quick change, and the Blackhawks now have two.
Kane shot, fought off Harding. Rebound, Koivu. Long feed to Charlie Coyle. Coyle could not get away from Hunzus. And now Stahlberg able to shield it beautifully. He'll work his way into the offensive zone. Victor Stahlberg shooting. Good save by Harding, who could not catch it cleanly, but he made a fine stop. And back goes Oduya.
Great speed by Victor Stahlberg. Straight ahead, pushing a defense back. Get a real high quality chance there.
Bickel, his pass deflecting. Hawks are changing the... Coyle might get to the goal. He centered a quick shot, cut up, and never got through. Good block, Roosevelt. And now Oduya. Shot a pass way in front of Stahlberg. He's going to try to hustle to save. Icing. And they say no. The whistle goes.
Oh, right call made there, but real good hustle. Real good shift all the way around by Victor Stahlberg. And again, Pat, when he becomes so dangerous is when he goes straight ahead. And this is exactly what he does. That's pretty good defense, but he's going on. Look at how much room he has there. Ryan Suter knows the speed that Victor Stahlberg can create. And when you push straight back, you're going to buy yourself some time. And that's a good stop there from Josh Harding and an outstanding shift. Even though Stahlberg didn't win that race, Pat, great effort. It'll be a trickle down, a domino effect.
Yeah.
Right through the lineup to see the effort like that.
Stahlberg able to hoist this one. Bickel with a bouncer. Couldn't get it settled down. And now Seabrook will pound it deep. Setoguchi couldn't get it beyond Letty. Kruger got help from Frohley. In a lot of traffic, though. Couldn't get rid of a shot. And the puck cleared to center, then swatted out of midair beautifully by Seabrook. Well, it is baseball season. He took a pretty good swing at that one.
I'd probably put him in the five hole somewhere. The Sox or Cubs.
Now Taves trying to get away. Suter, boy, Suter looked like he might get caught. He was moving forward, trying to backpedal against Taves, and great play by Ryan Suter. That could have been a real problem for the Wild on that sequence. They get it into the offensive zone. And now a corner battle has Clutterbuck handing it loose. Bouchard lost it to Hossa. Out comes Marion Hossa. Jonathan Toews chipped it in there. Hawks wanting to change on the go. The Wild are making some changes as well. Now Koivu gets in, chipped away by Letty. Here comes Patrick Kane in there. Kane with a shot off the mark. Hjalmarsson kept it. Al Gilbert tries this side. And it bounced back into the Chicago end.
Any opportunity, the Wild defenseman, Pat, they're just getting them. They're just shoveling it up. They're moving it ahead, not trying to make plays, making sure that the puck exits their zone. The Blackhawks forwards want to continue with the forecheck, and Blackhawk defensemen got to be aware where the forwards are for the Minnesota Wild as they are exiting their zone.
Patrick Sharp has only played four games since March the 8th. We're at the end of April here. Another Wild dump it in there. Duncan Keith. Put it on the stick of Andrew Shaw. In it goes. That's really been a regular occurrence for the Blackhawks here in the first period, having to dump it, not often able to carry it in. Bickle, his shot smothered, and here comes Suter. A good pass. Oh, Cullen couldn't hold it, or he was gone. Ryan Suter, a great feed. Seemed to be right there for Matt Cullen, but it escaped him. Now, that was good news for Corey Crawford of the Blackhawks, because he would have been in. 6.5 remaining in the first period. A Minnesota goal from Cal Clutterbuck as the visitors in front. Welcome back to the United Center. And coaches, management, personnel always talk about postseason experience when they reference the Stanley Cup playoffs. And a decided edge in that category to the Chicago Blackhawks. Look at that, 11 different members. Now, seven guys are in the lineup tonight with no playoff experience as far as Minnesota's concerned. But look at the leaders. Danny Heatley's not even available for the entire series. So that number for the Wild even goes down from what it might have been. And we mentioned that this earlier, but because we talked about experience, five of the six Minnesota Wild defensemen in this game have never been in a postseason game before in the NHL. We'll see if that shows itself in any form as we move on. Saad gets in against Suter. Shooting. Good save by Harding on the short side. Well, it's chipped to the boards. Taves got there. Keith touched it across. Hjalmarsson had a bouncer, though. And the Hawks will have to touch back up.
A lot of the attempts, Pat, that the Blackhawks have been taking on Josh Harding have been waist up. He's a big guy. I like to see him try to challenge him along the ice. Force him to use his feet. He hasn't played a lot of hockey. He hasn't played a full game in 2.5 months, so challenge him around his feet. Don't make life easy around his arms and the glove. Keep the puck on the ice every once in a while.
But also, Eddie, I mean, the Hawks have really not had a lot of zone time, and he's been able to see every shot, is my point. Not a lot of net presence so far against Chicago attempts. Pass just out of the reach of Sharp. Radziak put it back in.
Dump it in, dump it out. I mean, that's pretty much it is for the Minnesota Wild, knowing that they can't play a wide open game, and when you get up one goal.
Here's Kane moving in. Patrick Kane rolled it back. Roslovall's long shot never got past Suter. And Zucker cleared the zone. Nobody was sure what Sharp was going to do there. Patrick Kane was anticipating a dump, and it didn't happen. I don't know if nerves is the right word to say it, Eddie, but the Blackhawks out of sorts here in the first 15 minutes of this game. Statistic. And we love this statistic because we love Original Six teams. The history of the league right on this graphic, and it's been a while since all six have been able to qualify for the postseason, but it's
amazing, really.
Isn't that
think
something?
About it,
yeah.
It's great. It's great for the game. but kind of too, well, not more than kind of too bad. You get it that Detroit has to leave and go to the Eastern Conference. That's a lot more fair to their franchise, but now the Hawks will be the only original six in the West. But we will get to see everybody next year when the schedule gets put together. You'll play everybody in the East, home and road. Wild trying to get it back toward the middle. They ice it, bounce high into the air, coming down to Seabrook. Now Gilbert nearly turned it over as Stahlberg got into his lane, but Koivu with some support. Ingo Koivu. Zach Parise, who's dumping, went off a leg and out of play.
Well, stopped by Harry Carey's Italian Steakhouse on Kinsey this Sunday for the Blackhawks' official Road Watch party. The Hawks Ice Crew will be on site offering fans a chance to win Blackhawks signed prizes. And every attendee will receive a playoff rally towel. Go to ChicagoBlackhawks.com for information.
Well, they dropped that unfairly, so we'll try again with 4 minutes left in the opening period. And the Blackhawks in the first 16 minutes have had only five shots on goal, and I'm not sure we would call one a great scoring chance yet. So you got to tip your hat to the visitors who have been able to gum things up and prevent an end-to-end racehorse type of period, which would certainly favor the home side. The Wild coil able to clear the zone. Bolig put it right back in, and we like a moment ago when this man Suter was back for the puck. Bolig got a pretty good piece of it. That's exactly what you want to do. You're going to see a lot of Ryan Suter. You want to take a piece of every opportunity you get.
You're not going to get that from a lot of Blackhawk forwards. You talked a lot about it. So the guys that are on there get an opportunity. You got to make life awfully difficult for them.
And Eddie, 17 minutes played. Suter's been on the ice for over nine of them, according to our great stat man, Dave Ross.
Well, 33 minutes, I said, before the game started.
Right,
I mean, in that situation, I mean, understanding the totality of this first game and the schedule working out.
Taves for Hossa, the shot. Never got through. Nice block, Scandella. And Marco Scandella will chip it deep. He's going to get to it first. Grabbed by Oduya. Now Taves checked. Here's a long shot. Fought off Crawford. He gave a rebound, but Oduya there, and it's cleared to Saad. Brandon Saad for Marian Hossa. The shot and a save by Harding. Rebound to Clutterbuck, able to send it out.
A lot of one and done, Pat, on Josh Harding. So the Blackhawks understand is anytime they get that puck inside the blue line, no need to panic, no trying to do too much, is that puck's going to get to the net, and all the players on the ice have to realize that it's going there. So you got to try to get the second or third chance opportunity after the initial shot.
But there have been a few rebounds, a few loose pucks after he made the initial stop.
And he will give up some rebounds. He's a big guy. He's going to cross rebound, shoot the puck on the ice.
Coyle shot well wide to Kane. There goes Sharp. Here's the bank pass out of his reach. And the race for icing. One by the Wild.
Well, Friday night, the Hawks are back in action on Comcast Sportsnet. Home to a special hour-long Chevy pregame live here from the United Center. Watch Hawks Wild Game 2 Friday night at 7:30 right here. You know where. Comcast Sportsnet. Joe Quinville just having a conversation there with referee Brad Meyer.
Zucker got the draw. Rolled it back to the line. Jared Spurgeon brings it around. Going to be held in by Scandella. And Hanzus goes off the boards. That did not get out, but he fouled up. And Scandella went out of play. Marco Scandella, talk about this briefly, but the Minnesota Wild had every expectation he would be on their team. He was playing in the minors, and right before the lockout ended, he got hurt. Then when he got a few games and started to play with the Minnesota Wild, he was really not himself, not playing very well. They sent him to the minors. He spent most of the, virtually this whole season in the minor leagues. But
Mike Yeo this morning, when he was asked about why Scandella was brought back up to open up this series, he said, well, you know, I think he can eat up some minutes, and, you know, we're going to count on Ryan Suter and Jonas Brodin so aggressively that, you know, we need somebody that can be out there on a fairly regular basis. He thought Scandella would be that guy, but wow, you've been in the American Hockey League virtually all year, and your first action in months is a playoff game. Here's a two-on-one. Brodziak cuts in. Donovan down. Wait, shoots. Call for the save. Rebound. Oh, he made a great second save. He gave a rebound, Crawford, but Brodziak on the second bid tonight.
Well, what an opportunity here. Brodziak goes around Duncan Keith. Brent Seabrook buys some time. Great stop and an outstanding glove save off the backhand chance from Kyle Brodziak. And in that situation there, somebody's got to try to put a body on Brodziak so he doesn't get a second chance. But what a stop. Two huge stops there late in this first period.
Half a minute remaining in the first. Hoyle looking for a pass. Finds Sturgeon. Sturgeon, he put it in. Parise to the corner. Coils in deep. Stripped away by Tave. 20 to go. Hossa's got it. But boy, the sticks and positioning of the Minnesota Wild just outstanding here in the opening 20 tonight. Hossa's in behind. Jalmerson. Left it for Hossa. Tried a shot that was blocked. And the Minnesota Wild's defensive posture has been brilliant to start this series.
Protect the middle. Keep everything to the outside. And understand when there is no opportunity to create offensive pressure, it's retreat. It's stay five guys back. And so far, they've got a 1-0 lead after one.
Six shots for each team in the opening frame. The only goal coming from Cal Clutterbuck. Certainly an opportunity that Corey Crawford would like to have back, but that's the shot that has Minnesota in front at the end of one.
Back to United Center. Game one, Western Conference quarterfinals. The Hawks trail the Wild 1-0 as we get ready for the second period.
Take a look at how these teams matched up during the 48-game regular season. Of course, the Hawks, the second highest scoring team in the league. A little bit surprising that Minnesota's team defense was only in the middle of the pack. But they're an awfully good face-off team, as you can see, and special teams should favor Chicago. But as we mentioned earlier, not likely to be a whole lot of special teams play in this series. Minnesota Wild was shorthanded less than anybody else in the league. The Hawks were fourth fewest times short in the entire NHL.
And to that point, Pat, with the power plays or lack thereof, when you get one, could be the difference in a game.
Oh, for sure.
Or yeah. A series. No, I mean, anticipating 5-6 game series, whatever you want to call it. I mean, if a team's going to be shorthanded three, four a night, somehow, some way, you've got to get on the board on the power play.
Koivu and Taves have a little trouble lining up.
And the second period of Blackhawk playoff hockey is brought to you by your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Honda dealers.
Backhand shot, fought off Crawford. Coyle got it to the net. And there's a penalty coming up here, Chicago. And it's going to be a penalty on Parise for running into Crawford. But Eddie, that's the third time in 20 minutes of play that outside speed from Wild wingers has been effective.
Oh, what an opportunity here. Turnover in the middle of the ice. Here comes Charlie Coyle. Gets in. Corey Crawford, Pat. He wasn't sure where that puck was. And Zach Parise goes hard to the net. Gets pinched off a little bit there by Brandon Saad and Duncan Keith. And doesn't put on the brakes until really late. Goes crashing in to Corey Crawford violently. So here's that opportunity, Pat. Yep. Power play early down. Great opportunity here for the Hawks.
Kane out of the corner, right to the goal, and the puck escaped him as he was trying to stick handle. Now it came loose to Cullen. Matt Cullen able to work it back the other way.
Interesting power play here, Pat. I don't remember Marian Hossa playing the point on the power play when the Blackhawks have been 5-on-4. Seen it 5-on-3, yep. But not 5-on-4. That's where he is on this power play.
He's got it along the boards here. Now Taves.
No stick for Clutterbuck.
And he's out in front of Kane right now. Kane put it to Hossa. Hossa hangs on. Why don't you get it to this side of the ice with a guy with no stick? They keep it in the middle. Here's Taves, a shot. Good save. Harding, but Kane! Harding! Oh, a great save by Josh Harding with Kane having him one-on-one.
Unfortunately for Patrick Kane, from our vantage point, Pat, it looked like this puck was on edge. It looked like it was rolling when it got to Patrick Kane. Big stop there from Harding. And Patrick Kane walks in here, Pat. Would have liked to see Patrick Kane get there a little sooner once the pass went to Jonathan Taves to be on his way to that area there. But what a stop, though, by Harding. Moving right to left. That's huge.
Wild win the draw. And a minute of power play time remain. Letty and Seabrook have Sharp, Saad, and Kruger up front on this power play. The second half of the power play, Saad was checked as he was ready to shoot. Now Koivu bumped by Sharp, who took the puck away. A clearing attempt, good keep, Seabrook. Now the Minnesota native Letty gave it back to Seabrook. In behind is Kruger. Sharp now. Seabrook going back door. Here's the shot. Good save by Harding with no rebound. There was some net presence that time, and Harding gave him no second chance.
Pat, we're going to go back to that play with Marian Hossa, Jonathan Taves, and Patrick Kane from our Xfinity Telestrator. This pass is going to happen, but Patrick Kane, as soon as that pass happens, he's got to go to the net. The pass happens, he waits. Now he goes, it's too late. And that's the difference. That 5 feet that he would gain as that pass is going to Jonathan Taves to know where it's going, that's the difference between a wide open net or shooting the puck into the crest of the goaltender.
Hossa, top of the ring, centering, that's picked off and cleared the other way. Back comes Kane, gets the line, Kane centers.
Backhand pass, and as Harding is going down, Marian Hossa shoots this puck about 6 inches off the ice, right under the pad of Josh Harding, and the Hawks with a huge goal. But what a pass, the timing pass, an area pass by Patrick Kane. Lay it out to Marian Hossa, let him skate into it, and those quick hands of Big Hoss ties it up at one.
Here's Stahlberg trying to go wide. Hit hard by Stoner. And Clinton Stoner in the first period was on the ice for two shifts. He's got the puck here. And a good pickoff by Roosevelt. Zucker got away from Roosevelt. He skates in, penalty coming. Here's Koivu trying to center. Down went Oduya. That's a good breakup of a pass by Johnny Oduya. But the Wild, having just yielded a power play goal, now will get their first chance of the night.
Boy, Jason Zucker has had a real good first 22 and a half minutes of this playoff. He's created some great chances in that first period here. He creates a chance, draws a penalty to Michael Roosevelt. 2-on-1, moves the puck over to Mikko Koivu. I thought a chance had to shoot the puck right away, but he pulled it to his backhand. Wasn't able to get the puck to the net or even pass the puck over. So at one end, an opportunity for the Hawks on the power play, and now the Wild get their first power play.
They were in the middle of the pack during the regular season on the power play, finished the year with only one goal in 5 games, one of their last 9. And now they get ready. Shaw, I should say, a Frolik able to win the draw, but it didn't get out. Suter moves to the middle of the ice. A long wrist shot blocked by Frolik. And now Ryan Suter was on the ice, as Eddie told you he would be. 11 minutes out of the first 20. Koivu gets in. Bronziak chipped it loose. It goes out. Hawks try to change quickly. Back come the Wild. Bronziak had to stop at center, though. And Jared Spurgeon reorganizing. Suter. Spurgeon chipped it. Retrieved by Oduya. Now Jalmerson on his backhand able to hoist it. A minute remains on the Chicago penalty. Now Bouchard able to field the bouncer. Gilbert has to get back. 40 for the Minnesota power play. Brodin got it to Gilbert. In it goes. Now it's back to Brodin at the line. Put it across to Gilbert. The 19-year-old Jonas Brodin. Matt Collins got it now. The veteran takes a look. Brodin to Cullen, centered it. Gilbert couldn't field the pass. It came to the goal, and it's saved by Crawford. A couple of sticks got to a loose puck. And Crawford in the right spot.
I think that was Setoguchi. Good thing that Tom Gilbert couldn't shoot that puck right away, Pat. That one-timer as it came through the box of the Blackhawks. Quick pass right here. If he's able to shoot this puck, he gets a great quality chance, but it just explodes off his skate or his stick. And there's Devin Setoguchi, former San Jose Shark. Knows the Blackhawks extremely well from a couple of years ago when he was in San Jose taking on the Hawks as the Hawks went on to beat the Sharks, sweep the Sharks, and win a Stanley Cup. But a good stop again for Corey Crawford.
Saad in as a replacement, able to win that draw. That will finish the penalty time.
That's huge. That is a huge job there from Brandon Saad. Gets a pat on the back from Michael Hanzus, who happened to get kicked out of the faceoff right before that.
Both the teams at full strength now. Tay is able to fight through a check, and here he comes. Taves for Roosevelt. Back for Taves. Picked out of midair. Good play on a back check by Parise. And back goes Keith. Now Spurgeon safely chipped it out of there. Oduya tries a long pass, chased down by Hossa. Hossa now leaves it. Pass from Hanzus didn't connect. Roosevelt getting back. But here comes Suter for the Wild. Again, Roosevelt. Hanzus took a hit. Gets help from Stolberg. Good backhand pass finds Oduya. Kane with it now for Johnny Oduya. Spin center tip. Oh, what a save by Harding. A great chance for Hanzus, and he got a good shot away. And Harding made a fine stop. Back comes Kane. Kane gets in and was forced back out of the zone. Good work, Bouchard.
Well, that chance for Michael Hanzus all started because of a real good exit by the Blackhawks in their own zone. You pointed out, Pat, Victor Stahlberg with a beautiful pass to Johnny Oduya, who made the pass to Michael Hanzus, who was going hard to the net.
That puck out of play into the Chicago bench. Early in period two, the Hawks, on the strength of a power play goal, have caught the Wild.
Stolberg to Johnny Oduya, and watch the hustle here of Michael Hanzus. This is the way you do it. Move the puck, move yourself. Oduya, get the puck to the right guy in the offensive zone, give and go, and there's Hanzus. What a stop by Harding, but it all was because of the exit out of the zone. The great passing and support by the Hawks that created that quality chance.
Hanzus, who played 11 games as a member of the Hawks, had 5 points, was a plus seven in the 11 games he was here at the end of the year. Now Gilbert goes the other way. Stoner up the boards. Lutterbuck looking to shield it. They'll try this side, and Bouchard has time to take a look. Clayton Stoner will bounce it in. Seabrook pressured Spurgeon, a steal. Didn't expect the D-man to be up there, but he was for the Wild. And now Brodziak. Got checked by Letty. But the Hawks didn't get the puck back. Centering pass taken away by Letty. He comes out. Sharp. An extra move to the blue line. Forced an offside whistle.
Well, Hawk fans, put down your razor and enter the Comcast Sportsnet Playoff Beard Challenge. Submit pictures of your beard's evolution throughout the playoffs, and you can win a men's grooming package from Floyd's. To enter, register online at csnchicago.com before midnight tonight.
That's when I got to have my suit back. Right, midnight tonight.
Well, everybody in the contest is battling for second place. I don't know who's going to surpass Olczyk. Bickle working the corner. Is rubbed off, and Rosenthal forced it loose to Shaw. Tried a long shot that never got through. Andrew Shaw waits for everybody to get back onside. And the Wild comes away. Zucker rolled it ahead. Setoguchi chasing. Oduya just able to get there. Collision in behind between Setoguchi and Rosenthal. They both want him on the deck.
Setoguchi, another run at one of the Blackhawk players. That was Bickle he took a run at.
And Shaw couldn't get the puck under control. It wound up off a body into the Chicago bench.
Boy, pretty close to too many men on the ice as well. They're good thing it was a high stick.
Well, Thursday, the Bulls look to close out the book on the Brooklyn Nets. Tune in as the playoffs return here to the United Center for Game 6. Join Neil Funk and Stacey King. Neil and Stacey. Stacey and Neil. Bulls Nets Game 6 Thursday night 6:30.
Comcast Sportsnet. How about that game on Saturday, Pat, here at the United Center? Triple overtime. Bulls winning Game 4.
Yeah, I'll be honest with you. Watching some of that game. Here's a wraparound chance and a save by Crawford. They got another whack, and finally the whistle goes, and finally Mitchell got pushed aside by Seabrook, but I mean, he had maybe one or two extra whacks, and Seabrook finally able to get him out of the way, but maybe a pause too late.
Well, you're taught to play until you hear a whistle, and that's exactly what Torrey Mitchell does. He comes in there with support. Little late coverage there by Nick Letty, and there you see the stick keep hacking at Corey Crawford, and there you see Brent Seabrook pushing, and then hits that stick up high a little bit. A couple body shots by both players. And that's the way the playoffs are going to be. Not a lot of room out there, and you got to scrap and claw for every piece of real estate on this rink.
Hayes able to chip it ahead. There's Hossa. Gets in for Saad. Brandon Saad shot. He's looking for Hossa tip. And it just failed to connect. Coyle taken down. Goes back to his goalie inadvertently, but Harding will take a whistle. Charlie Coyle, just 21 years old. One of the Minnesota players with zero playoff experience, but they got him in a trade, and he was the piece they were looking for. Was that part of the Heatley deal?
Yeah, came from San Jose.
And by the way, I mean, there's a big part of their offense, Danny Heatley, unavailable for this series. The late season injury that required surgery.
And also, too, he got hurt actually against the San Jose Sharks, Pat. That was a game where Heatley got hurt. I think he got in a confrontation there with Marc-Edouard Vlasic. Yes. And you know, Jason Pominville as well, a late season acquisition at the trade deadline, the former captain of the Buffalo Sabres coming to Minnesota
And really, Coyle is in his spot. If Commonville was available tonight, he'd be playing with Koivu and Parise. And
I think Coyle's
a major loss.
Yeah, I think Coyle's better suited to play with those guys.
Oh,
I think he's a little quicker. I think he can get to those areas where Commonville can't. Great player, but probably more suited on another line.
Hanzus out of the corner. Did not get to the front of the net, but here's Oduya with a long shot. Soaked up by Harding. No rebound.
Pat, I want to give a quick playoff shout-out. Get well to Rochelle Roggewin, the mother of Adam Roggewin, one of the fine media relations men of the Blackhawks media relations department. And we hope she's feeling better after a little surgery today, and we're thinking about the Roggewin family.
Frolik trying to shot. Oh, good toe save by Harding from a tough angle. Frolik got it to the net. And Harding kicked out the left pad. Spurgeon brings it around the board to Pierre-Marc Bouchard. Now, this is going to be icing. It gets all the way down, and that does happen.
Well, Hawk fans, be sure to grab your official Chicago Blackhawks Stanley Cup playoff gear. The Reebok Blackhawks roster t-shirt and playoff puck are on sale right now. That's the roster t-shirt and the playoff puck. Visit ChicagoBlackhawks.com for more information.
Now Bouchard works in. Roosevelt took him off the play. Taken by Oduya. Looking ahead to Hossa. Hossa for Toews. Back to Hossa. Offside is the call. We're halfway through regulation time in the UC tonight, and it's postseason time. Have your head up. You're going to get hit.
GMC professional grade saves, and congratulations to the Blackhawks, and in particular, Corey Crawford and Ray Emery. The Blackhawks winning the William M. Jennings Trophy for the fewest goals allowed in this 48-game regular season. And just great work all season long, and the consistency that both goaltenders have played with all season long. Congratulations to Corey and Ray. And Ray Emery not backing up tonight to Corey Crawford, still banged up a little bit, and hopefully see Ray back in a Blackhawk uniform real soon.
Even though a shortened season, to play 48 games and not give up 100 goals, wow. Kudos to those guys, and nice award to pick up. But one thing I really like about this group, and you've seen and heard the same things, Eddie, the Jennings Trophy, the President's Trophy, a record-setting start to the season. None of that makes any difference to these guys. They've been talking about it since day one. It's all about now. It's all about the second season. All those things are very impressive, and it was a great regular season. But if this postseason doesn't go the way it was planned, that'll put a real damper on the attitude about what they've already accomplished. Sharp, but Toews was going for a change. Oops. And icing coming up the other way from the Wild.
The second period has been a little bit more wide open, Pat, than the first one. More opportunities for the Blackhawks to create the speed right before that last TV timeout. The offside play with Toews and Hossa. Didn't see a lot of that open ice in the first period. I think why in the second period is because of the long change. Your bench is the farthest away from your defensive zone, so a lot more changing going on, a lot more room and maneuverability.
Stoner back for the Wild. Al Gilbert. Cullen's touch pass is picked up. Rink wide. Zucker right in. He shoots. Oh, and the Shot well off the mark.
I think he was looking to pass, Pat. He looked like he turned that left hand over and just turned it over, looking for a stick there.
Gilbert, a long flip shot, never got to the net. Setoguchi had it taken away, too sharp. A rink wide finds Kane. Patrick Kane hangs on, dropped it to Sharp, had to put it in behind. And the Wilds, Gilbert, moved it up the board. Setoguchi dumped it. Minnesota changing. Seabrook able to fight through the check of Mitchell. The puck stays in the Hawks zone. However, it's up off the netting, out of play.
Pat, from our Xfinity Telestrator, I want everybody to keep an eye on this left hand of Jason Zucker. And the reason why I felt like he was going to try to pass is because at the end, he turns his hand over. And it's almost for you golfers out there, is when you turn your hand over, you're going to automatically snap hook it. And if you're going to shoot the puck at the net there, you're going to throw your hands right towards the net. And I don't think there's any doubt he was looking for a stick going hard to the net. And for all you young hockey players out there, think about it. How often do you get the puck on your stick and have nobody in between you and the net and be 20 feet out? Not very often. So what should you do? Put your head down and shoot it as hard as you can at the net.
You can be sure. We saw that conversation while you were showing us that, Eddie, with the veteran Matt Collins. Yeah. You can be sure. That's what he's telling him.
Never a bad play. Get that puck to the net. He's been good tonight, Pat.
Oh, boy, hasn't he?
He has been really good.
Terrific. Here comes Shaw into the zone. He'll snap it off, and it came back to him off a leg. And then it's loose to Mike Rupp. And the Wild able to dump it. They'll change. Crawford makes a direct pass to Letty.
Had a couple of good plays like that exiting the zone.
Stahlberg gets it into the Minnesota end. Pulls up. The rink line picked off. Clutterbuck the other way. He's got the Minnesota goal. Cal Clutterbuck, he'll shoot again from a similar spot. And Crawford able to handle that one. Now Suter. And back goes Rosenvall. Here come the Hawks. Bowling going wide. Snapped it off. It's fought off by Harding. Suter takes over. Now Frolik. Into the corner, hoping for Kruger. Kruger fights his way out in front. Couldn't get rid of a backhander, though. Jalmerson. Into the corner. And Bowling, and his pass deflect the other way.
People looking for a penalty there with Marcus Kruger getting knocked over.
Here comes the Wild. Parise with a long wrist shot. Blocker to side. Crawford. And out the other way is Taves. He's up with Hossa. Taves for Hossa. Weaving and shooting. It never got past Brodin, who made a fine block. Then Gilbert. Lost it to Hossa, but the Wild finally able to get it out of their end. Keith shoots it back in. Saad brings it around for Tate. Brandon Saad in behind. Taken away Gilbert, and Zucker tapped it free. 5 minutes to go in period two. 1-1 the score.
Yeah, that was a dangerous play there with Taves coming through the middle of the ice.
Hossa's got it now. And Taves from the corner. Side to the front of the net. The puck got into the area, but the Wild able to jam it loose. And Cullen couldn't get it out. Hossa for Saad. And the Hawks were changing as Gilbert takes it back from Minnesota. In every which way at center. Finally corralled by Kane. Patrick Kane dropped it back. Here's Rosenvall. His pass deflected away from Kane, resulting in an offside whistle. 4 minutes to go in the second period. Minnesota's had only 11 shots so far in the game, but they're even with Chicago.
Well, as Pat made mention a little bit earlier, there's NASCAR driver Danica Patrick, who will take part in our celebrity shoot the puck during the second intermission.
Well, she's bearing down.
I know, yeah, she's got it. She's got to follow through, though. Talked about Jason Zucker's turning the hands over their partner. Let's see. They're always turning to the left, right? On the car, so right-handed. That's not bad. I put it right in there. Here's Mike Yeo, head coach of the Minnesota Wild. Our pass crossed, Pat, back when we were both members of the Pittsburgh Penguins organization as coaches, and he's a terrific coach. He was an assistant coach when the Penguins won a Stanley Cup a couple years ago. So he's definitely got the experience. Not as a head coach, but he certainly knows what it takes to win.
And the general manager of the Minnesota Wild was with that organization, Chuck Fletcher. So some familiarity there. And Bill has had a chance the last couple of years. Here's a centering pass from Hunza's all the way through. And Coyle very calmly settled it down. Nice play by the kid, and the Wild get out. Here comes Parise. Back Parise, checked by Nick Jalmerson. Puck loose on the boards to Patrick Kane. Kane, good pass to Sharp, quick shot, nice glove from Josh Harding. And Kane again making something out of nothing, and Sharp got a chance because of it.
Not a lot of room for Patrick Kane. What he's doing, Pat, he's drawing two Minnesota Wild players to him, and he's able to distribute the puck. There's one, there's two. Two within, 5 feet, 6 feet? And then Patrick Kane knows, if there are two guys over here, somebody's going to be open. And a quick hands of Patrick Sharp. Didn't get a lot on it, Pat. Not sure if it would have hit the net or the crossbar there, but a great play, as you mentioned, by Patrick Kane as he entered the blue line of the Minnesota Wild.
Bickle working the corner here with Spurgeon. Hit hard by Bickle. Ryan Suter fishing for the puck along the boards, and a big hit by Bickle, and now an offside play. I'm sorry, I said Suter. I believe that was Kanapka that Bickle got. My bad. But 28, not 20, and kind of excited when you get a chance to run over Ryan Suter like that, but instead it was a guy with no points this year, Kanapka.
An important guy for the Minnesota Wild because he's really good on faceoffs. And our BMO Harris Bank Check replay. Brian Bickle knocks Kanapka right to the backside. Good opportunity, didn't run out of position. Made him pay a price.
Well, do you? To Roosevelt. There's Shaw. You looked out. Almost took an ear from Pumpkin. Oh, I'm sorry, but that goes out of play and a whistle.
Well, the first 20,000 fans enter the United Center on Friday. This Friday, May the 3rd, Kentucky Derby Eve. Kentucky Derby Eve partner. Receive a Blackhawks rally towel courtesy of BMO Harris Bank, Magellan, and Chicagoland or Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers. Visit ChicagoBlackhawks.com for ticket information.
Kentucky Derby Eve, or as is otherwise known, a sleep-free night for Ed Olczyk. A good keep by Koivu. Put it in behind. Coyle takes a look. Charlie Coyle left it, and Tave got help from Keith, and they are checked, and Koivu unable to corral it cleanly. Chalmerson put it in there. 2 minutes to go in period two. 1-1 the score. Hossa kept it in. And a penalty coming up. Keith and Koivu were going at it, and a penalty here, Chicago, Duncan Keith. Got a little too aggressive with
Chicago
Nico
number two,
Koivu.
Yeah, Tim Peel with the call, and Duncan Keith was going right at Mikko Koivu as that puck was exiting the zone. Well, they both went down there, Pat, and then there you see the stick, the slash by Duncan Keith, knocking the stick out of the hands of Mikko Koivu. opportunity for the Wild, second power play of the period.
Cullen wins a draw. Gilbert to Cullen. Right, a long shot. Tip. Oh, I think that was a redirect. Good save by Crawford. Maybe his best of the game, and he's made a couple. And Oduya able to clear it.
Oh, what a shot there from Matt Cullen. In your right, Pat. That puck redirected about 12 feet out in front of Corey Crawford. He was looking left, and it just hit him. Center square.
Bouchard dropped it. Brodin. Now Gilbert takes a look. Here's Brodin. His long blast is blocked. Now here's Taniguchi, who tried a shot that went off a stick, and Oduya hammered it back the other way.
Oduya's made a couple of good plays while the Blackhawks have been shorthanded in the second period. Huge plays, especially with the long change I made mention of a little bit earlier.
Final minute of period two. Checked in the corner. It goes out to Suter. Now Spurgeon. Ryan Suter. He'll look to Koivu. Tees it up and fires. Good. Blocked by Rosenvall. Now Koivu again. Or I should say, Koivu to Suter. There's Mikko Koivu to Ryan Suter. No lane. Spurgeon. Suter. Koivu. This flip shot. Good save by Crawford through a screen. 20 seconds remain. Spurgeon moving to the middle. Now put it across. Suter. Back door is Parise, but they couldn't find a lane to get it to him. And the puck off a leg, out of play.
Good play there by Frolik. Not a good decision by Ryan Suter to go to the backhand.
Now indeed, Parise trying to center. It deflects. And a whistle.
Well, 0.8 seconds remaining, but here's that chance for Matt Cullen. Shot right out, and yeah, right off the stick of Devin Setoguchi, and that is an outstanding stop. Very similar to the end of the first period, Pat. It was Kyle Brodziak that made had the two opportunities, and Crawford shut the door late in the second period. It's Devin Setoguchi with the redirect. Terrific stop.
So we just need a face-off here with 0.8 left.
Yeah, they're trying to, Wild, they're trying to get more time on the clock. The referees say you'll have nothing and like it.
And that will finish period two, a period in which the Wild got 7 shots on goal. They've had 13 in the game. The Hawks had 10. They've had 16 in the game. And the Minnesota Wild scored early in period one. The Hawks on a power play scored early in period two. A sweet dish from Patrick Kane to Marian Hossa, and bang, it's 1-1. Back inside the United Center, the Hawks and the Wild will head to the third period in a 1-1 duel here in game one of the opening round. Assistant coach Jamie Compan has a headset on for us. Do you talk about the Minnesota Wild the way you usually talk about the National Predators? Patience is awfully important here.
Well, you know what? They've been playing desperate playoff hockey for the last 5-7 games here, and they're at playoff pace. And you know, we got to get up to their speed. Last period we got better as the period wore on, but you know, they protect the house really well. They come back. They want to get foot races. You know, we got to shoot on the rush here. We got to get more shots to the net. We haven't created enough action at the net and had second and third opportunities.
Jamie, just if you can expand on that a little bit, is what did you like better in that second period from the first period that allowed you to play a little bit better?
Well, we got our legs moving. We got pucks behind them. We got chips and same-side chips and support. We had speed to the puck. It was really important to make their D turn and get after them. And in the first period, we played right into their hands.
Jamie, so far this season, you guys have not really focused a lot on matchups. You know, you roll your four, and do you anticipate that at some point may change at all?
You know what? Right now, we're confident in our four lines, and we're confident with whoever we play put out there against the other opposition's lines. So, you know, it's worked so far, and that shows a lot of confidence in our team, and it makes our team feel good about themselves and that everyone's contributing.
When you were talking about the first period not really going the way you were hoping that it might, nerves play any part of that? Was everybody just a little bit too ramped up? How did you see it?
I think we were too anxious. We didn't have composure with the puck. And hey, give them credit too. They came out. They had a game plan. And they stuck to their game plan, and they're continuing on here. So we got to slow them down, and we got to make sure that we start dictating the game and not play into their hands.
All right, appreciate a couple minutes. Thanks, Jamie. Good luck.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Jamie. Just a couple seconds left on a Chicago penalty as the Hawks clear the puck the length, and now both teams at full strength.
In this third period of Blackhawk playoff hockey is brought to you by Toyota. Let's go places.
Parise checked by Hossa. Now Taves. And the puck bounces around. Jonathan Taves. Had it knocked away back to center. Keith there. Duncan Keith will send it around. He'll actually take a long shot, and Harding stayed home. They clear it out.
Good idea.
Rodine rolled it loose. Cullen put it in. Setoguchi. Devin Setoguchi's long flip shot is picked off by Oduya. And Saad into the zone, but Setoguchi took it back. Here come the Wild. Zucker to the backhand, turns with a turnaround attempt that was well wide. Oduya up the near boards, and it's going to be held in by Spurgeon to Cullen. And Cullen spins away from Saad, but the puck rolled free from him, and Saad comes away. Going to chip it ahead for Kane. He drives around, skinned down the right side of the net. He shoots. Good save by Harding. A great area pass by Brandon Saad, but Kane unable to finish with a point blanker. Now back comes Hanzus. Sends it in. Stoner. Goes off the glass. Boy, and the Wild have done a lot of that from their defense tonight. Off the boards, off the glass to make sure it gets out. Now a loose puck in front, and Hanzus sort of shanked it. It was rolling on him. Then he put it wide. Here's a steal by Gilbert. Now a pinching Shaw got to the corner, looking towards Sharp. And Bouchard gets help from Gilbert. Pinching Letty kept it in. Finally, the Wild able to retrieve. Tom Gilbert moved it ahead. Clutterbuck couldn't hang on cleanly. Shaw gets the line with a long snapper into the, just on the tip of the glove of Harding. And back to center. Here they come. Konopka rolled it in. Mitchell waits and shoots. Partially blocked. Good play, Roosevelt. Mitchell got it back. Turns it around. Shoots. And Crawford hugging the post. Able to keep it from crossing the line. And then a little net presence will draw some attention.
Well, what an opportunity. But you made mention, Pat, Michael Roosevelt with a huge shot block on a two-on-one. And here's that chance for Patrick Kane. Goes right around Marco Scandella. And I don't know if Harding got a stick on that or not, but opportunity. Forecheck by Victor Stahlberg. Support by Patrick Sharp. And watch Michael Hanzus. He's going to come right in here and has a wide open side and just misses it short side. Puck was on edge. But the forecheck by Stahlberg, great support by Sharp, and a great pass created a quality chance.
Here's the draw. Cleared in behind. Doyle trying to jam it out of there. Well, the Hawks Bolig came up with it. Frolik, good pass from Chalmerson. Frolik moves in, shooting. Harding made the save, it's loose. And winds up around the boards and out. The Wild happy to accept an icing call after that little rush turned in by the Hawks created a good chance.
Well, your vote could put Patrick Sharp on the cover of EA Sports NHL 14 video game. both to place Patrick Sharp in the round of 16, where he could then square off head-to-head with other NHL players. Vote early and often. Vote now at ChicagoBlackhawks.com.
Coyle threw it into the corner, hoping for Parise. Chalmerson arriving first. Back comes Kruger. A long wrist shot into the glove of Harding.
Hey, look at the ice time pad of Marcus Kruger. 8-plus minutes. Michael Frolik. 6.5 minutes. Brandon Bolig. 4-plus minutes. A couple of those minutes for Frolik and Kruger were on the two power plays for the Minnesota Wild, so not a lot of ice time at even strength for that fourth line.
Saad for Hossa. Marian Hossa in his 131st postseason game. Taves has it now against Suter. Taves looking to drive center, and it's loose in front. Hossa couldn't get his stick free, and Harding able to locate. Look at that traffic. 6 or 8 bodies within a foot or two of the blue paint.
And 5, not including the goaltender, Josh Harding from the Minnesota Wild. Everybody coming down and we heard Jamie Compan talk about it, Pat. We talked about how he's talking about protecting the house area. I mean, that's right in front of Josh Harding. I mean, look at this all-white jerseys around a couple of Blackhawk jerseys. And they do protect that area extremely well, so the Hawks are looking for a second-chance opportunity, so don't refuse any opportunity to get the puck to the net.
Taniguchi bothering Seabrook here. Well, the Wild able to get it back. Brodeen, a long clip shot, never got through. Too Sharp. Patrick Sharp looking to pick up speed in against Suter. Tees it up, shooting. Good save by Harding, no rebound.
Judge attendance is 21,428.
Tell us straight for everybody out there, when you heard Jamie Compan talk about the house, this is what coaches will talk about. This is the area that they want to protect. You know, and if you want to put a door there or whatever, it looks like a house, that's exactly what it is. But that's what they want to do, protect the house. So in order to get inside there, you got to get people, you got to get traffic, you got to get second, third chance opportunities in order to get inside that house. And they're going to give you everything to the outside, but they're going to protect the most dangerous area of the ice. Sorry, I didn't have a chance to put any windows in there, partner. But.
Looking for a chimney, you know, what about some bushes in front, trees. Rather barren landscape.
Well, it is that time of year. It felt like it was 1,000 degrees day here. Right. It was playoff hockey weather, I'll tell you that today here.
Finally. Aduya turned it over under pressure. Bouchard the other way. Tees it up. Fires. And can't take profit. Rebound. He made a second stop on Brodziak. It's in behind. Oduya rolled it over to the board. And Kane able to get it out of there.
Oh, what a chance there for Pierre-Marc Bouchard. Made a quick little stop up. Got the puck to the net. Kyle Brodziak.
That's an offside play, so we'll be able to look back at it. This is one of the best sequences in a while for the Wild offensively.
Pretty simple. They got inside position, left part of your screen. There's Brodziak, stops in front. Good stick there by Michael Roosevelt. Real good stick, but the initial play, not from a great angle. Good stop by Crawford, and then the Blackhawks do a good job of coming back and protecting their house area.
Here's a Stahlberg steal, tees it up. Good blocker from Harding. Rebound to the corner, and Bickel went down. And the puck control by the visitors. They're able to clear it back the other way. The race here for icing is won by Seabrook.
Pat, always talk about going to school from our Xfinity Telestrator. Look at the positioning right here of Josh Harding. He is well outside the net. So this is where maybe you fake the shot and then you continue to the outside. But he comes down like that, there's nothing there. I mean, there's absolutely no room to shoot. So maybe you want to have patience with the puck, hold on to it a second longer, make a move. Because when a goaltender's out that far, he's going to lose his net. Well, that's where you want to maybe try to hold on to that puck a second longer, fake the shot, change the angle, maybe slide it right behind him.
Koivu goes to the corner. Here's a shot from a bad angle. Crawford stopped it. Now Seabrook, he'll just fire it back the other way, and the Hawks will take an icing call. Well, the Hawks, Eddie mentioned this, but in fact, the Minnesota Wild are going to go home after the game tonight because this series doesn't resume until Friday. See an 8:30 start time for that one. Then Sunday, an afternoon game in Minnesota. And the series will continue on just about every other day until the end. If it goes to seven, the game six and seven would be back to back. Brodin. Check by Bolig, a steal by Kruger. But the Coyle got it back. And again, here's a one versus four matchup. The Wild have their best line out there. Koivu's got the puck. Threw it in behind. Oh, and a stick came up and got Zucker. Penalty Chicago. And Zucker was reaching for a puck in behind the Hawks net. He dropped quickly and...
I don't know if he's cut, Pat. If he's cut, it'll be a four-minute penalty.
Does not appear to be that way now. We'll let you know when we come back. It is a two-minute penalty, and the Hawks will be short in a moment.
Well, there's Nicholas Hjalmarsson. Watch his stick come up and catch Jason Zucker. Right in the mouth, only a two-minute penalty. Power play for the Wild.
In the game, though, sorry, Eddie, this will be the third straight time the Hawks will have been shorthanded, which dates back to early in period two.
The rotation that the Wild were using on this power play to get the defenseman to kind of set up, Pat, and have one of the forwards circle out way high. So I have three players out near the blue line to give them an option on whatever side of the ice to shoot that puck from.
Frolik couldn't get it past Suter. Ryan Suter to the middle. Put it across. Here's a long shot. Sticked away by Crawford. It's out of play.
Boy, a missed opportunity there for Michael Frolik. Hawks won the draw, Pat. He was not able to get the puck out of the zone, and the Wild kept it in. Face-off. Frolik comes in. He drops down. He's got a lot more time here than he realized, Pat. He did get some pressure there, but you got to take a step, and you got to pound that around the glass. Corey Crawford changes a stick, and let's get ready to try to kill off this penalty kill situation.
Oh, a bad hop off a partition. Parise couldn't make a play, though, as Keith got to him very quickly. Nice recovery by Duncan Keith. And back comes Suter to Brodziak. And a pass of himself off the boards. He succeeds. Center, quick shot. Good block in front. Rosenthal is loose. Winds up in the corner. Taken by Brodziak. Back to Suter. Koivu tried to center. Hit a stick deflected off the side of the goal. Rosenthal. Challenging behind, and it's loose to Koivu with a stop shot and a good save downstairs by Crawford, and it's cleared beyond Suter. Still a minute of power play time for the Wild.
Oh, what a play by Kyle Brodziak. Great stop by Corey Crawford.
Setoguchi with some speed in on Oduya. Devin Setoguchi. Going rink wide, Pierre-Marc Bouchard with a shot. Soaked up by Crawford, no rebound, and Collin was lurking. That's a good save with no second chance by Crawford.
Well, we've seen this a lot, Pat, where Minnesota Wild forwards have really used the speed to the outside. Devin Setoguchi gets his puck to Pierre-Marc Bouchard, and look at Corey Crawford. No second chance opportunity. Here's this opportunity. Watch Rodziak. Passes his puck to himself. Great part of his screen. There's Koivu. Not sure if Roosevelt got it or not, but I think Crawford was the guy that eventually kept that puck on the outside.
Faceoff win, Hanzus. Now Jonas Brodin. Pressured by Saad. Able to get it up the ice, though. Cullen. Pushed it in. Allen behind the goal. Rolled it to Zucker in the corner. Or Bouchard, rather. He rolled it back to the line. Here's Tom Gilbert. And now Cullen tried to center. It goes all the way through. The Hawks penalty over. Both teams full strength. Taniguchi threw it off the side of the goal. Cullen is checked to the corner. Bouchard after it there. Taken away. And Oduya rolled it out. This one bounces back in. Taves captures. He races in with no help. Taves in the middle. Oh, he got rid of a shot. It went just wide. He was one against three and got a scoring chance. Brodziak to the other end on Roosevelt. Right in. And the puck rolled away from him just to the last moment. Taves the other way. Letty into the zone. His shot kicked aside by Josh Harding, and now Hossa out of the corner trying to muscle his way in front. It's loose to Kane with a shot and a save by Harding. Now is it covered to the crease? It's still loose. The puck went in the net. No goal is the indication for Brad Meyer. He's going to say he blew the whistle. And I don't even think we're going to go to video review here. He said the play was dead before the puck crossed the blue line.
Yeah, emphatically pointing at that left circle. The way Patrick Kane reacted, Pat, it looked like he saw where this puck was. Watch Patrick Kane. He's going to come flying in here. He sees that puck under. Is that Spurgeon that's down? And here comes Patrick Kane, and he just pitchforks it in. You got Hossa there. You got Taves there. And just a mad scramble. Patrick Kane came in and got that puck loose. So, again, the referees are instructed, but they don't see the puck, blow the whistle.
So they're incensed in the stands, but the play continues. Bickle set it. Oh, it deflected before reaching Stahlberg, who was open momentarily. And that one winds up back at center. We're halfway through period three. Konopka goes high off the glass and bounced over the boards into the wild bench. And 9.5 minutes remaining in regulation time. Still tied at one.
Well, Morning Skate Live, presented by Athletico Physical Therapy, returns this Friday, May the 3rd at 11 a.m. The Hawks Morning Skate here at the United Center will be streamed live on ChicagoBlackhawks.com and on mobile devices via the official Blackhawks app. Hosted by John Weiderman and the great Troy Murray. The 30-minute Morning Skate Live will feature a full preview of Game 2 with social media interaction with fans via the Morning Skate Live hashtag. There's that word again, hashtag. Comcast Sportsnet Chicago will also air the show on tape delay beginning at noon on Friday.
This one is sent into the wild zone. And back comes Torrey Mitchell. Roosevelt able to retrieve. And by the way, in the first 50 minutes of this game, Ryan Suter was on the ice for 27 and a half of them, or 26 and a half of them. And now a pass deflects away from Taves, who will hammer it deep and look for a change. Brodine fires it up the board. This one's going to get all the way down, icing Minnesota. And Josh Harding, I mean, what an amazing story. We told you that he's played very sparingly this year. In fact, he's played 41 minutes since February the 7th. I mean, that's all he had before coming in as an injury replacement tonight. Diagnosed recently with multiple sclerosis. And incredible that he's still able to be a professional athlete. Part of the reason he didn't play a lot past the early part of the season was really having difficulty with the medications they were giving him, and really was not it was not being handled that well by his body, and he had some tough reactions to all that, and had a couple of games early in the season where he was a little off and just really not playing as solidly as he typically would. And there really is basically not played at all for a couple of months here. And he's come into this game and faced 24 shots, and only one has gone in so far. He's been terrific, and a chance for the Wild. Tucker, out came Crawford. Tucker dug it out, a wraparound, and a goal might have been saved by Chalmerson. It's kept in Scandella. Stripped of a good stick, Chalmerson. He's able to clear it to center. Kane's got it. Patrick Kane, he's able to find Sharp. The shot blocked by the backside of Spurgeon. He was turned the wrong way, facing the inboard, Spurgeon, but able to make the block. Here comes Letty now. Pass missing Seabrook. And Scandella has to ring it back around. Jared Spurgeon cleared it up the boards. Picked up by Seabrook. Bickle put it in. Comes back to him, but quickly checked. And now the Wild, Bouchard. Wrapped up along the wall. Bickle comes away. Well, this one bouncing again into the Wild bench.
What a pass by Matt Cullen for that chance for Jason Zucker from our Xfinity Telestrator.
That's about as far out as Corey Crawford's been all night, right?
He knew the angle, but Matt Cullen did a great job. Before he got to that puck, he almost interfered the stick of Nicholas Jalmerson, who came over to make that play, Pat. And an all-in-one motion. Interfered with the stick, and then an all-in, that same continuation, passed that puck right over to Zucker. And what a stop by Corey Crawford.
Roosevelt cleared it up the boards. Here comes Frohley. Bruner checked in the corner, but able to roll it back. Here's Oduya. His long blast is off a leg. Bowling taken away by Mitchell. And now Roosevelt. Leave it his partner, Oduya. Tom Gilbert cleared it up the boards. Clutterbuck got it out of there. Brodziak able to knock down Seabrook, but now the puck dumped into Chicago ice. Letty is going to absorb contact from Clutterbuck, but made the play. The Hawks able to get out because of it. Here comes Tate. Harding plays it to the boards. Bouchard checked by a pinching Seabrook. Now Brodin goes off the glass to clear it to center. Brodziak into the zone. And good back pressure from Nick Letty. Now Letty takes over. And the crowd kind of gets some energy in the home team with a Let's Go Hawks chant. For this rush jammed up back into the Chicago zone. Crawford didn't know what to do, whether to play it or not. Now he's lost his goal stick. It's loose in behind. Zucker, or I should say, here's a center pass, not getting to Koivu. Picked off as Coyle tried to put it in front. And now it's dumped back to the other end.
Crawford has no idea where his stick is, Pat. Now he knows it's in the right wing corner. Yeah. It's as far away as you can get when you're talking about laterally from your goal. Look out here.
Zucker racing in on Chalmerson. And a takeaway by Keith. And still the goal stick lays in the corner. And Crawford now, he's not going to go get it. As Keith takes over.
Joe Quindle is barking at his guys on the ice. There goes Crawford.
Bickle moves into the shot. Good save with the blocker by Harding. Crawford now has the stick back. And in behind, a battle for the puck. Came loose in front. Setoguchi had it, lost it. Bouncing around to Stahlberg. Turned, centered. Oh, just away from Oduya. Now Johnny Oduya put it in behind. Stahlberg with it. 4 minutes to go. Stahlberg for Bickle. Shaw front of the net. Bickle Goes rink wide to Oduya. A long flip shot. Never got to the goal.
Oh, Spurgeon again with the block shot.
Here's Rosenthal. Trying a centering pass. It deflects to Oduya. No lane. Rosenthal on the other side. Oduya wants it. He gets it. He couldn't shoot it. Gave it back to Rosenthal. Now Stallberg. Great zone time here for the third line. Stallberg hangs on. Shoots one. Missed the net. Rebound held in by Oduya. Goes down low for Bickle. He's checked. Cullen took it away. A pinching Oduya will keep it in. Now Cullen unable to advance it. He wants a whistle but can't keep the puck underneath him. Hawks keep the heat on. Rosenthal will look to Shaw, who shoots. Good save by Harding, and the Wild get it out. And there are 10 exhausted guys on the ice. Most of them are changing, but Rosenthal's got the puck. He's got to stay out there. Now he'll get off. Great shift for the third line. Will momentum prove to be a factor here? Saad's pass was too far for Seabrook. Suter for the Wild. Cleared it ahead to Rupp. He's able to get it out. Rodin dumped it. Seabrook takes over. Taves is checked. Now Letty clears it up the boards. Bounce loose to Saad. He drives the goal. Saad for the winner. And a save by Harding. He took another whack. And Harding able to keep the puck from crossing the line. As there was a bunch of contact after he made the second stop.
Boy, that was Konopka and Taves that went hard into Josh Harding. I believe that this contact was made by Zenon Konopka on Jonathan Taves, going hard in that, looking for the rebound from the shot from Brandon Saad.
Saad let it go, and then the big contact, Taves driven into the goalie.
Well, if you joined us late, Josh Harding was supposed to be the backup tonight, but he ends up getting the start because Nicholas Backstrom got hurt in the pregame warm-ups. And for a guy that hasn't started a game since early February, he has been dynamite. Last chance, Brandon Saad, and watch Jonathan Taves going harder than that. There you see him get driven from behind. Well, you made mention of Corey Crawford losing a stick. Well, how'd he lose it? Right there, Charlie Coyle knocks it out of his hands, and Crawford didn't have it for a good, what, 45 seconds
yeah.
back?
Taves won a draw, so the play in the offensive zone, but Suter goes to that side. A good keep by Rosenthal. He was hit hard by Clutterbuck, but he managed to keep it in. Now Kane left it. Hanzus gave it to Kane. He eludes a check, a pass deflecting a couple of times, though, and it's cleared the other way. Rosenthal able to get it across to Oduya. Here's Saad getting in. Hossa right behind him. Saad trying to muscle to the net. Not that time on Scandella. And Saad got it back. But lots of traffic there, and Scandella finds Coyle. Charlie Coyle put it in. Keith rings it around. Now picked up by Saad. Brandon Saad put it to Marian Hossa. Here comes Taves. Hossa to the middle. He had a shot blocked, though. Saad is in deep. We go to the final minute of regulation time. As this one is gloved out. Nicholas Hjalmarsson. A bank pass missing Shaw, but no icing here. They play on. A steal. Here's Bickle shooting from a tough angle. That went off the stick of Spurgeon and up high.
A good idea there. Another good forecheck for this third line.
But how about that Spurgeon? He's been awfully good here tonight. Here comes Setoguchi. Bouncing puck. Just hopped away from Bouchard as he was ready to trigger. 20 to go. Setoguchi stops on Rosenthal, looking to drive. Centering. Broken up Oduya. And now picked up by Cullen. Centered it. That's picked off. And Shaw bats it free. And now the clock winds down, and this game is going to overtime. Game one of the opening round series. We'll head to extra time on West Madison Street tonight, in large part because of great work from that man who wasn't even supposed to play. Their workhorse, Nicholas Backstrom, hurt himself somehow during the warm-up. A last-minute tap on the shoulder for Josh Harding. Wow, 27 saves in the first 60 minutes of play. The Wild got a goal from Cal Clutterbuck 5 minutes in. The Blackhawks got a power play strike from Marian Hossa early in period two. Next goal wins. Beautiful springtime evening in the greatest city in the world, downtown Chicago, where the Blackhawks and the Wild have played 60 minutes, and it's not enough. We want more. And we're going to get more here in just a moment as we get ready to start the initial opening or overtime period. Time now for our KFC Fan Cam. Plus on hand once again here on West Madison Street. Is somebody telling him what's happening? Can he see anything?
I don't think he's related to the green men in Vancouver, is he?
Oh, I hope not. I hope not, because there's a family reunion you don't want any part of right there.
Well, something to keep an eye on here, Pat. The long change in this overtime, the first overtime. You got to be disciplined. So for the Blackhawks, their right winger and right defenseman cannot change unless there's wholesale changes prior. You can't leave because you're the last resort on that side of the ice.
And look at that. This man, no stranger to extra time. As almost every game in last spring's playoffs went to OT, and last couple of games against Vancouver the year before that. Now overtime in game one here, which is underway. Hossa rolled it to Duncan. Keith fired a long shot into the glove of Josh Harding.
Any opportunity, get the puck to the net. That is one of the message coming from the Blackhawk coaching staff. Pucks, people, to the net. Any lane that is there, take advantage of it. And the guys without the puck got to know that it's going to the net.
Bouchard chipped it deep. Now Letty takes over. Nick Letty. A lot of traffic there in the middle of the ice between the blue lines, as Eddie's been talking about with us all night. This one's going to be held in by Letty. Now Bouchard did not get it out. Rodin able to. Seabrook looks to Sharp. That's an offside play as Ryan Suter got right to Patrick Sharp, just as the puck did. And so Shaw was in a little bit early.
Well, this line had a really good last 5-6 minutes of that third period. Victor Stahlberg, Andrew Shaw, Brian Bickell.
Out there against the Cullen line in this shift, and Spurgeon's got the draw. That'll be offside. And for those of you who might have joined us late, not seeing the start of this game, Josh Harding on as a emergency, as an emergency, emergency goaltender tonight. Nicholas Backstrom hurt himself in the warm-up. He has not started a game in 3 months. His last start was January 30th. And he's been absolutely terrific in the Wild net. I mean, what unofficial count, I mean, how would you grade the scoring chances up until this point in the game?
I would probably say 10-5. Like 8 plus chances, 10-5 for the Hawks.
Here's Zucker. He couldn't get it all the way through. Bounce loose in front. Quick shot. Crawford able to stick it away as Cullen found the puck on his blade in a good position. I think he got whacked and he's limping. Cullen, that'd be a big loss for Minnesota if he can't continue. Zucker the other way. Dropped it. A shot and a save by Crawford. And the rebound over to the corner. Konopka after it there is checked. And now the Hawks, Shaw, rolled it to Stallberg. Stallberg goes crashing into Gilbert in the corner, and Stallberg won the puck. Stallberg battles to the middle, and finally stripped of it before he could shoot. Nick Leddy. Or Bickle jumped loose. Mitchell kept it in. But Leddy gets it back. To be an offside play again.
Well, Pat, you made mention of Matt Cullen. Watch Johnny Oduya. Sticks his leg out and impedes the progress of Matt Cullen, and that's a great stop by Corey Crawford. Tracking the puck, moving from left to right. And as Cullen was going down off balance, he found the ability to be able to control the puck and fire it at the net. And that was all arms because he had no lower body to use because of being thrown off balance and the desperation move there by Johnny Oduya.
The race for icing is won by Keith, and as my great partner speculated before the game, we were going to see a lot of Ryan Suter. He played 31 minutes out of the first 60. And the ice time leader in the NHL in the regular season. Not likely he's going to slow down. Coyle going to shield this in the corner.
Good pitch in there by Duncan Keith. Keep the play alive.
Everybody stationary for the moment. Came loose to Holston right in the back end. And a diving save by Harding. He had him down and out. Holston, but he couldn't lift it. Saad kept it in. Now Keith had his pass broken up by Coyle. And will it go far enough for icing? Yes. So the Wild now cannot change. They wanted to change him up. That cannot happen. But Mike Yeo has not used his timeout here yet tonight. I don't know if he will here.
What a chance for Marian Hossa as he walks all the way through. Quick little stick, and then off the shaft of the stick of Josh Harding, up and over behind the net.
And it's really Ryan Suter that got his stick so close to Hossa's that he really had no chance to lift it. Really nice defensive play by Suter.
Didn't seem like there was much happening. Pat, all of a sudden, Hossa's walking in.
Yeah. And we've had offside call, I'm going to say, half a dozen times here in the first 3.5 minutes.
Again, I think just with the long change here, Pat, in this overtime, you want to make sure that you have people back in a transition game. You know, the Blackhawks are as good as it gets in the National Hockey League when a transition goes from defense to offense. And the Wild has some guys that can jump in as well, so you want to just be 110% sure, as Crawford is there as he absorbs a shot from Cal Clutterbuck. Just not get caught out there too long as your bench is so far away in the overtime period.
And actually, in the first 60 minutes of this game, the Hawks actually out-hit the Wild 31-30, which is notable because out of the 48 games this year, there were only 4 times where the Hawks actually had more hits than their opponents. And of course, if you got the puck all night, you can't be doing any hitting. But surely Minnesota, as any team that plays against Chicago does. They always want to try to create a lot of as much contact as they can, try to get the Hawks off their game. And Blackhawks have certainly matched that physicality from Minnesota so far tonight. Spurgeon had a jump loose. Now taken by Frolik. Michael Frolik. Or Marcus Kruger. Checked by Brodziak. They will shield him away nicely. And then Clutterbuck taken away Frolik. Scandella. He's checked. Wild can't get it out against the fourth line. Good jolt there from Bolick. They'll go the other way. This is going to be icing Minnesota. Well, the Hawks Kruger line comes up with a good shift.
Boy, you got to use your timeout if you're Mike Yo, the head coach of the Wild. You got some tired hockey players on the ice. You know Joel Quenneville's coming with the heat. He's coming with Jonathan Toews, Marian Hossa, and Brandon Saad. And you get an opportunity to regroup. Minnesota does use their timeout, but look at the effort here. Marcus Kruger, this all started bad because Michael Frolik kept the play alive a little bit earlier than that. And look at the effort. I mean, talk about hounding the puck, tracking the puck. It forces the Minnesota Wild. That's a good play. I mean, that's a good play by the Wild. Instead of just doing something soft, you make sure you get it out of the zone and the mindset of we'll take a whistle and we'll take an opportunity to breathe a little bit for 10, 15 seconds if our coach decides not to use that timeout. So they get a good 45, 50 seconds here. And opportunity here for the Hawks with some momentum built from that fourth line shift.
All right, the draw. One by Toews. Letty, no lane. Saad's got it. Letty's one-timer is blocked. And now the Wild able to clear it up the boards and out to center. Toews back in. Toews put it to Letty up on the rush. Shooting. Good save by Harding. Rebound. Hossa had it escape him. Held in by Seabrook. Lines it around. Hossa. I should say Assad couldn't quite catch up with it, and Seabrook gets back. Hossa wants it. He's got it. Hossa in. Dropped it to Toews. Good back pressure from Setoguchi. Now Toews in behind to Hossa. Hossa back to Oduya. And the Wild able to get it back. Now Cullen back on the ice. Went down in the corner, though. And a good keep by Roosevelt, who was then checked, and the puck came out, then went back in offside.
Well, you made mention of it, Pat, the excellent effort. Left part of your screen, here comes Devin Setoguchi right there. Stick on puck, stick on stick, denies the opportunity from Jonathan Toews. Here's Nick Leddy with the chance, trying to go far side. Again, Josh Harding well out on top of his crease, well out of his net. I like to see the Blackhawks, when they get that opportunity, Pat, hold on to that puck, fake the shot, get the goaltender coming out, and then throw it back the other way for an empty net or on that same side.
Sharp shoots one. Shoulder save by Harding. Just got it up with his right side. Rodin got it out of there. Koivu put it deep. Keith back. Duncan Keith. Pass read by Suter. Parise with Jalmerson. Keith got it. It's jammed loose. Konopka took a funny hop out of the corner. Alertly Crawford got down and able to smother at the side of the net. Quenneville, Simon Kruger line, over the board. Sorry, Kruger's out for the draw. Shaw and Stahlberg out there as well, so Kruger out for the faceoff. Then Bickle will get back out when he can. Rupp's pass hit the back of the goal now. Seabrook, got it to Stahlberg. Dropped it back, turned it over. Rupp's got it. Mike Rupp, part of the fourth line here for Minnesota. He gave it to Mitchell, centered it. Stoner couldn't find a lane. Kanapka has no points this year. Left in the corner for Big Mike Rupp, 6'5". He spins it in behind Mitchell there. Back to Stoner. Torrey Mitchell with a shot. Oh, a redirect. That hit Kanapka. And a fine save by Corey Crawford.
Well, the Hawks were heading out of the zone, Pat, and Victor Stahlberg tried to make a pass back into his own zone, turned the puck over, and the Minnesota Wild created these chances. And look at that. What an opportunity there for Torrey Mitchell with Kanapka standing right in front. Again, the key, no second chance, no rebound given up. Outstanding work there from Corey Crawford.
Colin and Matthews here, and the draw to the Wild, quick shot, oh, goal post! Oh, the Kid Sucker had a puck that went an inch from going in. A board battle here. It's going to be held in. Penalty coming up, Chicago. And the Wild has Jason Zucker, who nearly just won the game, down and hurting. And Johnny Oduya is going to be sent to the box.
Well, here's the penalty. Right there, there's Johnny Oduya's stick comes up and catches Jason Zucker, who drew a penalty a little bit earlier in this game. But watch this chance here. The puck is just laying there. Zucker's got it. Air mails this right off the crossbar over the shoulder of Corey Crawford. Hawks will be shorthanded here. Boy, that rode the rail too, partner. Ended up on the right side of the shoulder of Corey Crawford and rode out the other side.
Faceoff win to Chalmerson. He's able to clear the zone. The Wild have had six shots on their three earlier power plays. Radziak sends it deep. Here's Parise banking it back to Suter. Ryan Suter across to Jared Spurgeon. Suter again. They get Brodziak to the top of the crease. Here's a one-timer by Parise. They never got through. And it's chased down by Frolik, who failed to get it out. Following up Keith. He got rid of it.
Big shot block, too, by Duncan Keith. Minnesota got into their setup, and I think that pass actually was too far in front of Parise to shoot that puck.
Now they get in. Rosenthal with a good stick. Taken away Hossa to Seabrook. Ahead for Taves. Taves in on Gilbert, who tried to he's going to get a penalty. Gilbert ruled to have hacked down against Jonathan Taves, and now it'll be four skaters aside.
Well, you made mention of the play by Michael Rosenthal and Devin Setoguchi. He had a chance to go wide. He decided to come to the inside, but watch Gilbert here. He just wraps up and squeezes that stick. So 4-on-4 hockey here in overtime. Man on man. Forwards have the D. The defensemen have the forwards.
And if nothing happens in the next minute, the Hawks will get a minute of power play time. Draw to the Wild. Cullen pass it to himself against Rosenthal. Brings it around Setoguchi. Centered it. It never connected with Cullen. Held in Spurgeon. Tried a long shot into the glove. Crawford, who had a good look at that.
I think Jared Spurgeon was waiting for one of the forwards at least get to the front of the net, whether it's Setoguchi or Matt Cullen. But Cullen made that whole play, Pat. There you see an easy save for Corey Crawford, but Cullen passed the puck to himself, chipped it over, got support. They went from low to high and created the chance.
Now the draw, won by Koivu. Suter, Brodin. Now Ryan Suter goes back across. Here's a one-timer and a save by Crawford. There was some traffic that time, but Corey Crawford able to locate.
Boy, what patience by the youngster, Jonas Brodin. Kruger loses the faceoff. Minnesota plays keep away for about 15 seconds here, and there was some traffic, and Corey Crawford really had to fight through that one. But Parise right there.
And after that last faceoff, well, here's a loose puck for Crawford. He's able to get it back in behind. Taves over the boards to get that defensive zone draw, which he did. And now Kruger to the other end will drop it back to Keith. And now the Chicago penalty over power play hockey Blackhawks for another 60 seconds.
Oh, my God.
Hossa into the zone. Hossa hangs on, dropped it back. Keith to Kane. Patrick Kane, they get Shaw to the front of the net. Kane going back doors. Hossa, Kane now shot it. It hit a skate. Hossa able to keep it in. Taves. Hossa now. Back to the captain. Shaw at the front. Here's Hossa. Hawks on the perimeter. Here's Kane walking to the middle. Spins back. Kane hangs on backdoors. Hossa, there's the pass. In front to Keith. Deflected just wide. And the rebound. Kane's got to hurry. The Wild able to get it. Clutterbuck cleared. Just a couple of seconds left of the man advantage. Keith sends Hossa over the line. Married Hossa with a shot. And a save by Harding, who holds on to it.
Well, from our Xfinity Telestra, the Blackhawks will get their rotation here. Stop it right here. Patrick Kane's going to throw this to Marian Hossa. Duncan Keith's going to circle in, and then the play is going to be set. The table is going to be set for Duncan Keith right there, and a good opportunity for the Hawks.
Well, when we come back, the teams will be virtually back at full strength. It'll happen in a moment. Welcome back to the Madhouse on Madison, where the Minnesota penalty now is over. They get it in. Here's Mitchell with a shot. He made a nice move to get it to his forehand, but missed the target. So both teams at full strength here. And Stahlberg chases his own chip. He gets there, centered out of the reach of Bickle. And Mitchell the other way, cleared it ahead. A long shot from Rupp is sticked aside by Crawford. A keep by Suter. His long shot hit traffic. Laid loose in front. Oh, a whiff. Well, the Wild might have had a good scoring chance. Bounce loose in behind. Taken by Coyle and a steal by Seabrook. Now it's taken by Stahlberg. Victor Stahlberg hangs on. And we got a Wild player. Rupp can't get to the bench. He's got no blade and skate. He's crawling over there now. And the puck is finally dumped into Chicago ice. But the rule to be offside, Mike Rupp. Looked like a newborn deer. His legs were going every which way, but kind of hard to skate when you got no blade in there. And there's the blade. You see referee Meyer bringing that over. Keith fanned on a pass, a steal Parise, but Jalmerson hacked it away from him. Now Duncan Keith, in his last 20 games of the year, was a plus 14. This one is cleared back into the Wild end. Harding nearly turned it over. It's Oduya. came all the way around, and Parise is rubbed off by Hanzus at center. Here's Oduya. They're going to head to Sharp. He's going to get in on Suter. Sharp to the goal. Good pump check, Ryan Suter, and no shot was taken. Now Hanzus down low for Sharp. Looks in front there at the back to Kane, and a shot hit traffic in front. Now a pass the other way. Did not connect with Setoguchi. Setoguchi got to it. Bounced it to the other side. And Hanzus able to get it out. It bounced to Kane. Kane getting in. Sharp's behind him. Kane shot no block. And back come the Wild. As they go end to end here, Bronziak pulls up. Now shoots it. Oh, he's hoping for a tip, but missed Setoguchi. And back come the Hawks. Throw lead for Kruger. Marcus Kruger out of the corner. Now here's a wraparound. Harding made the save. Rebound to Spurgeon.
No stick for Brodin, and then he just got a stick from Zucker, the forward.
Back in it goes. Taken by Bowling. He shoots. What a save by Harding. No rebound.
Boy, for about 90 seconds to 2 minutes, it really opened up here, but Patrick Sharp trying to take this puck to the net. You pointed out, Pat, a great stick. A great stick there from Ryan Suter. I like Patrick Sharp, the anticipation there, Pat. He got probably 135-foot pass right in stride there, seeing where the coverage was coming from. Was to the outside, no hesitation at all. Get the puck to the middle of the ice and give yourself a chance.
Coyle is hit by Bickle, but able to get it out. Ryan Bickle. And the puck was flopping around at him, so icing his whistle. Or excuse me, offside his whistle. Well, the Minnesota Wild, you know, we mentioned they kind of stumbled to the finish line. They won only six times in their last 16 games. And in almost half of those games, seven of the last 16, they scored nothing or one goal. They scored early tonight, 5 minutes in. On a wrist shot from Cal Clutterbuck, but the next 25 shots they've taken have been stopped by Corey Crawford. Here's Cullen. He left it in behind. Setoguchi helped by Zucker, then chased down by Rosenvall. Scandella runs it across. Gilbert ahead for Zucker. He had a jump loose, but able to tap it deep. Tried a long shot that's well wide to Koivu. Coyle stripped of it by Oduya. Back goes Suter. Around for Coyle. Jammed it loose, but Taves on it. Jonathan Taves stripped by Brodin. Hossa takes over. Taves in behind. Now Keith looks back to the captain. Grabbed this time by Koivu. Taves fights it loose. Tipped it back to Keith. Comes back to Hossa. He was taken down. They play on. Parise. Might have a 3-on-2. Here comes the chance for the Wild. Parise right in front. Big save by Crawford. Corey Crawford just saved the game against their most dangerous forward. Hossa to the other end. Into the middle. And a save rebound. Sharp. Harding able to cover it up.
Oh, what a chance for the Minnesota Wild. Corey Crawford again. A terrific stop. Here comes Zach Parise. Skate right, shoot left, and Crawford well out on top of that crease. Great blocker save. And at the other end, 2-on-2 becomes an opportunity for Marian Hossa. Patrick Sharp, unfortunately,
losing his balance and not getting a second chance opportunity at Josh Harding.
Kane with a long shot, hit somebody in front. Clutterbuck lifted ahead. Now Sharp ahead for Patrick Kane. Seabrook's up with him. Here's Kane weaving in a spinorama. Kane hangs on, bought some time, drops it to Lenny to Seabrook. One-timer! Tipped and saved by Harding, and he's able to hang on to it.
Well, Brent Seabrook jumps into the play, Pat, to make us a two-on-two, and eventually he's the guy that gets the shot. There's Seabrook. Great part of your screen. That's Brent Seabrook. Kane buys some time. Wait. Get the puck up. Get it over to Nick Leddy. And there's Brent Seabrook. Look at Michael Hodges standing right in front of the net. And a redirect. I'm not sure if Patrick Sharp got a piece of that. But what a stop by Josh Harding. And you see the numbers for Brent Seabrook tonight. They're looking for the puck, I think, Pat. They can't find the puck. I think that's what they're looking for.
Yeah, there's Tim Peel and Brad Meyer trying to figure out where that thing went.
There it is.
Hey.
All right.
That's lines, but Derek Gibson. By the way, you know, we mentioned this briefly earlier, but, you know, kudos to not only these officials, but every one of them who was awarded a postseason series from the... From the start of the year, there are now only 20 referees and 20 linesmen left for postseason work. There are two other referees and two other linesmen that are available for injury replacement should something happen. But kudos to these guys. They are graded more aggressively than ever all throughout the regular season. And those who grade out the best from the NHL office get postseason work, and that's why these guys are still going in the playoffs. Mitchell hit hard in behind by Shaw. Now it's loose ahead. Stahlberg's got it. Bickle up with him. Stahlberg for Bickle. Ready? Hawks win. Brian Bickle in overtime.
Support by Johnny Oduya. Off the glass, into the neutral zone. The speed of Victor Stahlberg. Up and over Ryan Suter. And then the perfect pass from Brian Bickle. Forehand, backhand. Nothing but the back of the net. And the Hawks win game one. And high fives and hugs all the way around for Corey Crawford, who made some A-plus saves in this game, and especially against Zach Parise in overtime.
Well, the Hawks grab the opening game of the series.
The number three star.
And let's get the three star selection.
Number 37, Josh Harding. The number two star of the game from the Blackhawks, number 81, Marian Hossa. And the number one star of the game from the Blackhawks with the game-winning goal in overtime, number 29, Brian Bickle. Please turn your attention to the Blackhawks bench. First, Susanna Collins is with Marian Hossa.
All right, Marian. It's never easy in the playoffs. Tonight was certainly no exception. Is this pretty much the kind of game you anticipated here tonight?
Yeah, definitely. They're a great team. They played good defensively, and obviously it wasn't easy tonight, but, you know, again, we find a way to win, and that's huge.
Well, overtime games seem sort of par for the course for the playoffs. I know you can prepare for these games physically, but how do you prepare mentally for these kind of battles?
Well, we know we have to play our game like we did during the whole season, and tonight I think we play a little bit slow period, but after I think we play much better, and we find a way to win, like I said.
One win, 15 more to go. How important was it to come out here and take this first game of the series?
Well, it's a huge, especially now we got 2 days between, so I think this is huge. You know, we got a huge win tonight. We can enjoy tomorrow and get ready back to work.
All right, Marian, thank you so much. Congratulations, Marian Hossa.
Our Alexis Pursuing Perfection player of the game is the guy who just scored the game-winning goal, Brian Bickle. Able to tuck it to the backhand and beat Josh Harding, who otherwise had been spectacular tonight. Bickle gets his fifth ever postseason goal in his 16th game in the playoffs in his career. And exuberance, rightfully so. The Hawks capture the opener of this best of seven series. Stay with us. Happy news coming up on John Crane's Hawk Forward postgame show. Pat Boyle and Steve Conroy to break it all down for you. For our award-winning CSN crew and for Eddie Olczyk, Pat Foley, hoping you enjoyed the broadcast. We know you enjoyed the outcome. After 16 and a half minutes of overtime, Bickle with a winner in a 2-1 Blackhawks win. Game 2 on Friday night. So long, everyone.